when I need it. So let me know when we're ready.
All right. We're real close to ready here. Yeah. I can feel the excitement building. Whoa, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, from Louisiana, the Braille Blues Daddy, Mr. Bryan Lee.
Thank you, Mr. Sunny Boy. Yeah. I hit the band. Yes, yeah. Somebody came up to me the other night. I was over in Venta Gorda at a place called the Blue Turtle. And this lady come up to me and she say, "Bryan Lee, the blues ain't funky. In fact, you can't dance to the blues." Well, now look at here, baby. If you don't think the blues is funky, fellas in the band, do you think the blues is funky? Uh-huh. I know Maurice. Maurice knows it's funky. Now look at here. You don't think the blues ain't funky, and that you can't dance to the blues? Well, baby, you got a hole in your soul, and I'm gonna have to pray for you. Look at here now. I wanna make some noise with the boys. Yeah. I wanna make some noise with the boys. May I please make some noise with the boy? Thank you. let's take it to the bridge. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I got a little New Orleans tune for you now. We hope you like it. From the Katrina Was Her Name CD. We're gonna do a little barefooting, baby. Yeah. One, two, one, two, three. Everybody get on your feet. You make me nervous when you're in your seat. Take off your shoe, pat your feet. Doing a dance that it can't be me. We barefooting. Sally was out of sight. Took up a wing and I and sneak us too. Doing a dance with a hot in his shoe. Barefoot with me all night long. Take off your shoe, go one more way. Come back and get a man. Another day with barefoot. Barefoot. I'm barefoot. Oh, we're barefoot. Let's do it, fellas. Because I can't help it. You know, I think my favorite artist was Smiley Lewis. And I first heard Smiley Lewis, I was just a kid up in Wisconsin, listening to the radio late at night. And I said to myself, oh man, that song Bumpity Bump, wow. I hope I get to do it someday. And guess what? The good Lord heard me. And I come to New Orleans, and on my six-string therapy CD happens to be Bumpity Bump. You guys ready to do some Bumpity Bump?
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, here we go. One, two, one, two, three, four. Yeah. A dog chased a rabbit, ran, hop, skip, and jump. I said the dog chased a rabbit, ran, hop, skip, and jump. The hunter tried to get him, but he hid behind a stump. He said, hey, Mr. Dog, what are you putting down? Hey, Mr. Dog, what are you putting down? I'll have a bone for you the next time you come around. But the dog say, Mr. Rabbit, I've heard that line before. He said, hey, Mr. Rabbit, I heard that line before. So you better start running, cause I ain't gonna let you go. They went hop, skip, and jump. Rap, bump, stop, and stop. Hop, skip, and jump. Rap, bump, stop, and stop. The dog was a gaining and his heart went bumpity bump.
Thank you.
much, everybody.
Bryan in this monitor, please, vocal.
Yeah. Thank you so much. What I'd like to do right now is another one of my tunes. I wrote this about a girlfriend I had. And I got a couple of ladies here tonight that I haven't seen in a long time. And I think you guys might, I don't know if you knew her or not. Her name was Angel, and at the time I thought, boy, I was in love. Problem was, yeah, I was old enough to be her father. So I thought to myself, well, we'll have some fun for a while. But one of these days, she's gonna wake up and she's gonna say, Bryan Lee, you're just too much of an old man. You know, you're too slow, and I gotta go. And she's done very well for herself. She got married, she's got two beautiful kids, and she got through nursing school. So everything worked out fine. But I wrote this song about her. It's called Louisiana Woman. Now we gotta get the bass player to start this thing. So Mr. Bass player, he's got it. Oh, we got the blues coming on.
Thank you.
please come back to meet me. Lose that woman. Girl, please come back to me. I love you, baby. Somebody stole my sheet music on that thing. Kept missing some frets. But the band, you guys are wonderful. You held me together. Now, you know, Joey was doing some great B.B. King stuff. Now, I got a B.B. King tune that I got a hold of, and well, I don't think it'll ever be the same, but you just never know. Anyway, this is for all you beauticians out there. Yeah, it's called the Beautician Blues. Yes. You know that A flat was Jimmy Witherspoon's favorite key to sing in. And one time he was, my band was backing him up, and my harp player didn't have anything to play in A flat. And so I said, Jimmy, I said, well, it's either G or A, take your pick. He said, hell with it. I'm not gonna do the tune, you know. Yeah, but all right, enough of this. I'm at a fine beautician and a real nice condition. She was long and lean, and you know what that means. A hard-working woman. I said a good loving mama. She make a lot of money. I don't need to worry about a thing. She work all day, dressing hair. Boy, you know I'm gonna get somewhere with my good loving mama. My hard-working woman. She make a lot of money. I don't need to worry about a thing. I meet the finest women from everywhere. Cause my baby dressed their hair. I'll be a lover boy. She treats me like a king. She make a lot of money. I don't need to worry about a thing. Oh yeah. Yeah. Hang on, man. Too much with horn players, and we got my favorite kind of horn section tonight: trumpet, tenor sax, and baritone sax. Yeah. Now, Robert Miller, why don't you play me a few verses? Come on, man. Blow that tenor saxophone. Come on, man. Yeah. It's my favorite horn section. There's one guy left. That's the man who's got them in the bottom. So, hey man, so play that baritone for me, man. Yeah. Blow Mr. Low. Yeah. Trash man. And fine, and every pound of love is mine. I'll be a lover boy. She treats me like a king. She make a lot of money. I don't need to worry about a thing. All right. Thank you. my goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Such an honor to be on this stage with such a great band, everybody. And my man, Joey Gilmore, I met Joey a long time ago. He might not even remember it. Me and my band had played a gig on a Wednesday night in Montreal, Quebec. That was a Wednesday night. Friday night, we had to be in Jupiter, Florida. So we left after the gig. We drove continuously till we showed up in Jupiter, Florida on Friday morning. Unfortunately, we got in about 10 o'clock, went to the hotel. They wouldn't let us in till 3 o'clock. And after being all those hours in the van, you know, you were just like, I just want to go and lay on a bed for a minute and take a shower, you know, and get myself together. Well, they finally let us in. So that night we get over to the club, we get set up and everything, and we're all just kind of sitting at a table eating, and a gentleman come up to me and he said, you know, I have a friend here tonight who's really very, very good. He'd be great to open your show. And I said, well, sir, we've never played here before. And I said, I don't know how the management would feel. He said, look, it's not going to be any problem. He'll set his amp up on the floor. He'll sit in front of the stage, and he's just going to sing and play and get the people ready for you. His name is Joey Gilmore. So I met Joey, and Joey played about 45 minutes. And I was like, how can a guy just be relaxed like that playing by himself? I can't do it. I mean, it just scares me to death, you know? That's how I met Joey. And I kind of followed him, you know? And he had that album out where the song is The Ghosts of Mississippi Meet the Gods of Africa. I thought that was rather interesting. So I bought the album. And lo and behold, not too long ago, me and Joey did a thing together over in Englewood on the west side of the state. Englewood on Dearborn in Englewood, Florida. We had a lot of fun, Maurice was there. And so we kind of had part of my band and part of Joey's band, and we had a hell of a good time. Then the next time, we were at the Phoenix Radio Awards, and here comes Joey. And everybody said, nah, man, he's sick. He's not gonna be here tonight. I thought to myself, well, what a drag, man, you know. But he showed up, and we did I did a song, and he sang, I played in a band, and had so much fun. And now here we are tonight, ladies and gentlemen. You know, yeah. You know that the way it is, most of the real bluesmen are gone. BB's gone. I said to myself, when the good Lord calls BB home, wow, it's going to be hard. He was a personal friend of mine, and I really miss him. We got Buddy Guy, and Buddy's still doing it. And there's a few other people that are, you know, doing it. But you know what? This man, who is an original blues man, deserves a whole lot more credit than he's gotten through the years. So please just give him a round of applause. My best friend, Joey Gilmore. Thank you, Joey, for letting me come here tonight and play with your band. I mean, it's such a pleasure. So what I'm gonna do now, because Maurice is such a nice man, back here on the drums, I'm going to call up my drummer, Mr. Bob Menzies, and we're going to do a couple of more tunes for you. So.
Once again, Mr. Maurice Dukes.
Yes, sir. He's a man who's got the beat. All right. Here's a little tune that I recorded in 1995. We're going to have some fun with this one. It's called Heat Seeking Missile. Yeah. I jumped on it. Yeah. Yes, sir, Sonny Boy. And you're going to have a solo in this one, Sonny Boy. All right. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
All right. Well, D isn't delightful. One, a two, and a one, two, three, four. Got something for you. I don't want you to ignore. You knock me out the way that you walk through that door. Such a good picture from your head to your toes. Somebody stop me or I rip off your clothes. I'm a heat-seeking missile, trying to zero in on you. I'm a heat-seeking missile. I've got some love for you. Sexy green eyes, cute little waist, those flakes that don't lie. I'm feeling dirty, I hope you are too. I want to jump in the tub, rub a dub dub, loving with you. I may heat sinking missile, trying to zero in on you. Yes, I am. Some love for you, Sonny Boy. Yeah, come on, Sonny Boy. Yes, sir. thank you. Thank you so much. You know, I didn't expect that my voice was going to be so bad tonight. I don't know why. It's just, it's a weird thing. So you're kind of getting the gravel Bryan Lee tonight. But, you know, it's just, you got to do what you got to do, you know. So look at here. Here's a little tune of my, not mine, Albert King thing that was written by a man by the name of Jerry Beach from Shreveport, Louisiana. Him and I became pretty doggone good friends. But just like so many others, he's gone. And of course, we lost Mac Rebenack a couple of days ago. And I'm still hurting in here, you know, thinking about it. Mr. Dr. John, what a guy, man. He was definitely from the school of cool. All right, enough of the talking. Let's get into the music. Says I play the blues for you. And we do all of the time. Yeah, one, a two, and one, two, three. Come on over to the place where I work, and all your loneliness I'll try to soothe. I'll play the blues for you. Just come on in. You might run across one of your old friends. All your loneliness I'll try to soothe. Yes, I will. I'll play the blues for you. Come on in. Set yourself down. Relax, order a drink. I wanna talk at you. You know, I get kinda lonely too. When I used to leave the absent house by myself. Unlock my door by myself. Take my clothes off by myself. Get into my bed by myself. And when I woke up, I was still there by myself. Had to get myself out of bed and make my own coffee. You know, loneliness can be a very bad thing if you let it get the best of you. In fact, I have heard of loneliness blowing some good people's mind. But look at here. If you dig the blues, you ain't gonna be lonely no more. So look at here. Me and my band, my guitar, I play the blues with you. I ain't got no big name. I sure enough ain't no big star. I'll play the blues for you. Yes, on my guitar. All your loneliness I'll try to soothe. Yes, I will. I'll play the blues for you. Excuse me a minute now, baby.
Thank you.
that's kind of funny. When you're visually handicapped, like I am, see, today, with the political correctness and all, I can't say that I'm just blind. Well, blind's too harsh of a word. Visually handicapped, that works better. I guess it's kind of like, well, it was a boy, but now it's a girl. There was a girl somewhere down inside of there and just had to come out. Oh boy. But you know, this man over here, Mr. Joey Gilmore, is such a good guitar player. I love to listen to him play. And I didn't realize that he was up here with me until the song before this one. And I said, wait a minute. You got guitars on both sides of you. Joey's up here on the stage. That rascal. I'm glad he's up here on the stage. Yes, I am. I'm going to do one more song. And I don't know what the deal is as far as we're just going to take a break and then we're going to, Joey's going to lead it and I'm going to follow, you know what I mean, like do a jam and, because it's Joey's gig, you know. So anyway, I'd like to do one of my tunes called Six String Therapy. Yeah. 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 I think it's best. I've been up here a long time.
All right.
Been having a good time. Let me get my chops together. Yes, yes. You know, it's funny. I love this key, guys. I love B flat minor. I don't know why. Yeah. As in beer. Beer flat minor. All right. One, a two, a one, two, three, four. But that's all I need. Oh, when I pick up my guitar, it make me feel, yeah. The woman put me down, stomped me in a deep, deep hole. The woman put me down, stomped me in a deep, deep hole. Every time I bend my string, it satisfies my soul. I went down to the grocery store and gave the man $100 bill. Yes, I did. I went down to the grocery store, gave the man $100 bill. Yeah. He said that I'd like to help you, blind, but that's only a one. Gave me a $99 thrill. Son of a gun. All right, Joey. Yeah. Gilmore. Hey, Daryl.
Hey.
I haven't given you a chance at all.
Not at all.
The you know, solo that guitar. So look at here. When we get to the top, show me what you got. Look at here. I got to go. But man, I had so much fun. You know, we didn't really get a chance to rehearse, but well, shucks. We had fun. I think that our man over here on the tenor saxophone, Mr. Robert Miller, deserves a lot of credit because he took my music and he wrote all the horn charts. And, you know, did a wonderful job. Yes, yes. And then he had to tell me one night when I was, I talked to him on the phone and I was relaxing, going to sleep. And he sends me a text message and starts telling me about Charlie Brent. And Charlie was a tremendous musician, but a great writer. And I had the honor of tuning Charlie's piano one time. It's a small world, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, well, I got to go. Joey Gilmore, thank you, my brother. Come on, give him a round of applause. Yeah. And how about my man on the drums, Mr. Bob Menzies? He was so nice. We weren't working tonight, so he was so nice to drive me over here from Bradenton and take good care of me. And he didn't know that he was going to get a chance to play. I think that's so nice. Thank you, Maurice. Yes, yes. All right. But the only man I didn't mention was the bass player. Definitely taking care of business. Yeah. All right. I'm gonna squeeze my baby one more time. It's good. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time.